Hi, actually, this is the second video which I've done with this stencil set. This is a gun, the Walter P99. I'm doing a skull design with the very small skulls, multi-layered stencil sets. I've got in the first video, the one before, you see the size comparison, so actually each skull will fit into the €1 coin. And still it has a lot of details. So this is the first stencil which I'm using with an opaque black. And as you can see, each skull has four parts, so I do now a variation of skulls. Just remember that you don't put two skulls that are the same next to each other, so always try to change into different skulls. So that was the first black, and now I'm doing with the same color and less opacity a gray. As you can see, the stencil is already used, so I'm not cleaning my stencil at all. I designed it myself, so I can work with, let's say, dirty stencils, because I can find in each stencil the next part where I can fit in the stencils. So I'm using this a lot on shows and custom meetings, and I don't have time to clean everything. So I developed this technique that in each part you can find the next stencil part to fit in perfectly. For example, here we got the teeth and everything around the eye sockets. So if you put this stencil over the white, over the black eye sockets, you get a perfect fit. So, and as you can see now, the skulls come out real nice. Before I have spoken about this, the blue and the magenta, they were transparent colors. So I'm using black and white as a opaque solvent based paint, and the other stuff is transparent solvent based paint. So the transparent color, everything that's white gets the color, everything that's black stays black. So that's the advantage of transparent colors. So now, normally you can say, you can stop right there and say it's finished, but you also can use different colors. Now I'm using a transparent magenta again, and then a transparent yellow or light brown. You can see the front, where there was a light blue, now turns into a green color, and the skulls get like this light brown color. So you don't have to do this, but gives a nice touch to the whole thing. And now you have to repeat the last stencil step again, so put on the white stencil and do some highlights again. So as you really can see, you can't look through the stencil to do the positioning, but still, if you orientate yourself at the black, you can put in the white perfectly. So I'm doing the transparent brown again. The more layers of color you do, the more depth come into the skulls. So you also can vary with different colors. And as you can see, you also can use a black again to put on some black details again. So now I'm doing the glowing eyes of one of the skulls. And now I'm using a transparent red, transparent yellow. For the eyes. So that's it, that's nearly finished. Some highlight for the eyes again. And that it. Okay, bye.